Hi there, welcome. Now that the RSVP list table exists in the database, the next step is to add data to it when a user RSVPs to an event. In this video, we are going to return to the RSVP form class we created earlier. Then, we will update its submit form method to insert the user entered form values into the RSVP list table. Let's get at it. Okay, with the RSVP list module loaded in your code editor, let's open the file rsvpform.php again. Recall that it is found in the custom module directory at rsvpform.php. Open it up. Excellent. Scroll down to the submit form method so we can work within it. The first thing to do is comment out the existing displayed message. Eventually, we can remove this code as soon it will be replaced with a different message. I personally prefer to comment out code before I remove it entirely, so I have a visual record of what I worked on. Commenting out the code first and then removing it, or just removing the code, is up to you. Nice. What we are about to do can be completed in three phases. First, we will initiate variables containing the values we want to save to the database. Second, we will construct the database dynamic insert query and execute it. And finally, we will display a success message to the user. Before we jump into writing the code to achieve those three phases, realize that because we are saving to a database, it is good practice to encapsulate our code in a try-catch statement just in case the database throws any unexpected exceptions. To do this, start with the try-catch statement itself. Super! Let's start phase one, initiating the variables to save to the database. Recall that the values we need to save to the RSVP list table are UID, NID, mail, and created timestamp. To set the UID, because UID was not a value submitted by the user, we need to programmatically obtain the UID of the active user. We can do so by typing the following code within the try block of code. This will set the variable UID to the ID of the current user. Note that Drupal's global method of current user returns an object of type account proxy, and it does not provide a fully loaded user object. For demonstration purposes only, I'm going to also type one of the most common approaches to load a user by its user ID. The code for loading a full user object is this. I'm showing you this code because often you will want to work with the values of the fields set on the user entity, perhaps such as first name or created date, for example. The RSVP list module doesn't actually need a fully loaded user object though. This is just for your learning. The other values of NID and email we can get from the form state variable. To achieve this, type. Notice that we're using the getValue method. The remaining value is the Unix timestamp of the current time. Although we could use PHP's native time function, we are going to leverage Drupal's way to obtain the current timestamp using this code. This also completes phase one of this activity. Well done, your code editor is happy. Phase two is saving these values to the database. We will use a dynamic insert query. Begin the query like so. Now that we have a query object to work with, let's establish the fields we want to insert into with the following code. Next, we can set the values of those fields in a similar manner using the values method like this. Brilliant! The final step of any database query is to execute it. Straightforward enough? Nice! That completes phase two. The final phase is to display a success message to the user. Let's keep it simple, like this. Fantastic! That completes the majority of this activity. However, we need to fully complete the code by handling the condition that perhaps Drupal throws an exception while trying to insert these values into the database. So now, go into the catch exception E code block. And again, let's keep it simple by having Drupal display an error message to the user. Amazing! You are awesome! This completes the code for this activity. Double check your code and save the file. Before making a quick trip to your site, let's refresh our minds with what we expect to see in the database after a form submission. We already know what the UID, email, and current time variables will be set to. However, it's not a straightforward assumption from this code as to what the NID variable will be set to. Remember, at this time, we have yet to display this RSVP form as a block on a node, so we need to refresh our minds as to what the default value for NID is. To determine that, scroll up to the build form method. And thankfully, we can see that we have already accounted for this situation with the code already entered. Foresight for the win! So the first thing that is done is to try to load the node of the current page. If there is no node to load, then the NID variable is set to 0. Okay, so we expect to see a 0 inserted into the NID field in the RSVP list table after form submission. Short-term memory activate. Super. Save the file again if you need to and head over to your site so we can check out our code. The first thing we need to do is, you guessed it, flush the cache. I'll do that now, and then I'll head over to my database to demonstrate that what I'm about to show you has not been predetermined like one of those slick proof of concept demos. This is the real deal. As you can see, currently there are no values inserted into the RSVP list table. Now, back at our site, I see confirmation that the cache has flushed, and I will head over to the RSVP form demo at /RSVP list demo. To save time, I'll enter a couple of seemingly valid email addresses. Example at example.com. Super. 42.parallel universe@example.com. RSVP success! Exciting! Heading back over to examine the database, I can see two new entries containing data of expected values. UID of 1, that's me as the super user, NID of 0, emails as expected, and timestamps seem rational. Obviously, the ID has been automatically generated by the database. Fantastic! Well done on completing this video and activity. We are well on our way to successfully completing the RSVP list module. Take a break if you need to. Healthy mind, healthy life. Happy learning.